Assalamu alaikum, grade 12 students. Today, I will explain the last document of Chapter 3, Genetic Identity of Individuals. In the previous document, you have learned about the DNA analysis by using restriction enzymes and gel electrophoresis that helps in the detection of a genetic variation of humans. Today, many techniques based on the usage of restriction enzymes and DNA analysis. So, in this document, we will recognize some of these techniques, mainly the steps and the use of FISH technique for the localization of a gene on a chromosome. We will define the genetic map, and we will also learn about DNA fingerprint and its steps. Finally, we will indicate the importance of DNA fingerprint technique. Because of the large number of polymorphisms observed in humans, certainly each of us is genetically unique, except identical twins. It follows that genetic variation and DNA analysis could be used to identify individuals much as classical fingerprint. The DNA analysis has developed a lot, mainly in two domains. The first domain is the construction of the genetic maps based on a specific technique. First, let's explain what is a genetic map. It is a type of chromosome map that shows the relative locations of genes and their roles. Take an example, the genetic map of chromosome 11 in document B of your books. Chromosome 11 contains 103,000 to 104,000 genes that provide instructions for making proteins. Most of these genes, once mutated, will lead to disorder or diseases. That's why you notice that the gene locus is named as the name of the disorder that will happen. For example, the location beta thalassemia is actually the location of the beta globin gene. Another example is the one indicating the position of the breast cancer gene. This is the location of a gene involved in the regulation of the cell cycle. The main technique which mainly helps in the gene map is known as FISH or fluorescent in situ hybridization technique. In situ means in place. It uses fluorescent labeled DNA probes that search for a specific gene to locate it on a chromosome. Let's learn the steps of this technique based on your book, page 67. Part 1. First, the cells have been treated to make them swell, and then they are fixed onto the surface of the slide. The slide is treated and the chromosomal DNA is denaturated into single strands. Then, special DNA probes are flooded onto the slide. The DNA probes are small pieces of synthetic single-stranded DNA that are prepared to be complementary to the sequence of the gene to be located. Once added to the slide, the DNA probes will hybridize with the denaturated DNA and any excess probes are washed away. Then, fluorescent labeled molecules are added to the slide. Those molecules are able to bind to the DNA probes. Now, excess fluorescent labeled molecules are washed away. The slide is then viewed using a fluorescence microscope. The fluorescent labeled molecules reveal the physical location of the gene of interest. So, FISH includes two main steps. Denaturation of DNA, that means the separation of the double-strand DNA by heating, and hybridization to a synthetic probe. The probe to be used in FISH should be carefully chosen to hybridize only the sequence of the gene of interest. It must be monolocus probe which binds to a specific sequence of DNA. The sequence found only once on the genome, because if the probe hybridizes sequences that are found in more than one gene, then we cannot locate a specific gene. FISH and other techniques allowed scientists to construct human genetic map by determining the loci of genes and the distances between them on all the human chromosomes. that genetic mapping brought up a revolution in disease treatment, where the ability to identify genes related to disease has an immediate impact on the diagnosis, treatment, and prevention of genetic disorders. Now, let's talk about the other domain that uses DNA sequences. It is the DNA fingerprint, which is the method of isolating and identifying variable elements within the DNA. This technique is also called DNA typing or Jeffrey's technique. What are the steps of this technique? Let's see, and you can based on your book, page 68. First, the DNA sample is isolated and extracted. This sample can be from blood, semen, or any other cell sample. Next, the DNA is digested into different sized fragments by restriction enzymes. Then, these DNA fragments are separated by gel electrophoresis according to size, where the smaller fragments migrate faster than larger fragments. Then the obtained bands pattern are transferred to a solid membrane, also known as southern blotting. Now, after the denaturation of the DNA strands into two single strands, radioactive labeled DNA probes are added. These probes will hybridize with specific sequences of DNA. Finally, the hybridization is observed by autoradiography. At the end, a picture of the radioactive marked DNA is created. The obtained pattern of bands for each individual is referred to as DNA fingerprinting and is uniquely characteristic for individual. Notice that DNA fingerprint uses multi-locus probes that are able to hybridize to repetitive DNA sequences. This way, the probes will fix to different bands at the same time, which allows the appearance of multiple bands on the autoradiogram. The DNA fingerprint is used in many domains. First, in criminal investigations. Samples are taken from the crime scene, like blood or skin cells. Then a DNA test is done to compare its results with the DNA of the suspects. In this case, suspect 2 is the criminal. Another domain is the paternity test. Since DNA fragments are inherited from both parents, DNA fingerprints of children should be similar to their parents' fingerprints. Some bands will match one parent and the other bands can match the other parent. That's why it is easy to determine the parents of a child by comparing their DNA fingerprint. Finally, DNA fingerprint helps in the identification of dead bodies. How wonderful it is to understand the structure and the function of DNA to use it. Not only for the identification of criminals or the determining of biological parent of a child, but also in other domains such as medicine, for example, in the diagnosis of genetic disorders.